So the first thing I want to teach you is how to re-tack your mat. It's not something that we do very often on air because it's a very short amount of time that we've got to show you the product. But it's important, especially when you're cutting dough flex. And this is dough flex, if you've no idea what I'm talking about. It's a plastic sheet, so there's no fibers. You can't tear it. So we need to make sure that it's really well stuck down. And what happens when you've got something like the Scan & Cut with a moving blade and a moving platform is the plastic wants to do that on your mat because it's being forced in different directions by the blade and the pressure of that blade, and then the mats go in opposite directions. So it's like, I want to move, and we need to stop it moving. Now, when you get the dough flex from Create & Craft, you've got a smooth side, and then you've got a side that is a little bit more textured, and it doesn't really matter which side you press down onto your mat, but I would say I use the textured side because it's got a little bit more grip. It's like, you know, when you put a tooth on paintwork before you repaint over it, it's that kind of feel, but you still need to make sure that your mat is nice and sticky. A brand new standard mat will hold it for a few cuts, but you will, in quite a short space of time, even though this isn't leaving any fibres on your mat, you'll need to make it stickier. So I thought we'd just do that from the top and then everyone knows how to do it. Now, Brother recommends that you cut the middle out of an old mat. Unfortunately, at the moment, I haven't got an old mat. So I'm just going to show you the way that I do it. But please, the most important thing, and this is crucial, is that you do not get any on this black area here or from there out, because this is where your rollers takes the mat into the machine. And if it gets glue on it, especially the pinflare stencil glue, which is super tacky, it will stop the rollers from taking your mats in and out, and then you've got a problem. So I'm going to show you the way that I do it. So I have a kitchen sponge with a sponge side on it. Don't buy a really expensive one, just buy cheap and expensive ones because you're going to throw them away after a few goes. And you want a plastic bag and then our pinflare stencil glue. Now, Brother UK have approved this to be used to re-tack their mats, so we're good to go, but you must not get anything on the outside of there, all right? Because if you do, and it causes a problem with the machine, it will void your warranty. Just being really upfront, but I've used this for probably 2 or 3 years now, and I haven't had a problem. So what I do is unscrew the lid, and I just put kind of a line on a piece of plastic. So if I just hold that up and show you, about that much. And you're not going to use all that, but the technique that I used to put it on, I just put it in a line like that, okay? Make sure that this is clean, the nib's cleaned, and you put the lid back on because it gets super sticky. And then take your sponge on your piece of plastic, I'll put it on my mat so you can see, and just dab this. So you're getting a really nice, light, thin layer. So if I show you the plastic now, you can see I've just dabbed it out there. And then I've got a nice thin layer on my sponge as well. Okay. Once I've got that, and I don't do it all over the sponge, I just do it about a third of the way down. I just literally put it in the top corner and just drag it down. So you're getting that glue. And then once I've dragged off that excess, I just go around and I dot it. And if you hold it to the light, you'll see it because it looks a little bit matte against the shiny adhesive that's on your mat. But just be very, very careful. If you want to, get a piece of card and put it over here. So take something like that, for example, put it there and then work up to that. If it's something that you think, oh, I'm going to get glue everywhere, just make sure that you don't. And then I'm just going to work down at the bottom here. And it's quite difficult to see because as you're pressing it on, it's almost clear. But you'll be able to see it if you hold it up to the light. And then I'll just pick up a little bit more of that glue. And I'll continue round, and I'll just make sure that I'm working quite methodically up and down in an area so that it's completely covered with that glue. Okay, and then the most important thing, and if anybody thinks that this isn't important, you ask Stephanie, because Stephanie once did this on air on a 12 by 24 inch mat, covered it in stencil glue and didn't leave it to go off. And she put a 12 by 12 piece of construction board on top of it. And it wasn't coming off that mat. So, and then she had to publicly apologise on air to me because she'd made a mess of the mat, which I just thought was absolutely hilarious, but it was a lesson learnt. So just go in, and then you must leave it to dry. Now on the bottle, the instructions on the bottle actually tell you to put a little bit of water with it. That's if you're using it on the back of a stencil. So you could use this on the back of your stencils. I tend to use the Cadence spray stencil spray, but this is just as good on the back of your stencils. If you're going to use it for that, add a little bit of water because you don't want it to be too tacky. And then I'll leave mine for about 10 minutes. And when I come back to this and I'll show you during one of the demos, I can literally put my hand on it and pick it up. So it really gives it that good adhesive back. So you're not having to buy your mats continually because that's the pain, isn't it? You know, and I want you to use your machines as much as possible. So if we can re-tack our mats, even better. So that's what that's all about. And now I'm going to teach you how to cut dough flakes. So I'm going to show you on the SDX, but I'm going to talk you through how you do it on the CM machine and what your settings are. Okay, see you in a minute.